In previous video, we have seen what is speed. The distance traveled by the object in unit time is called speed. The rate of motion can be specified by speed. Now, the rate of motion of an object can be more comprehensive if we specify its direction of motion along with its speed. And the quantity that specifies both the direction and the magnitude of speed is known as velocity. So, the velocity is the quantity which specifies both the direction of the motion and the speed is called velocity. Velocity is equal to displacement upon time taken, that is displacement per unit time. Or you can say that velocity is the speed of object moving in a definite direction. Or you can say that velocity is distance traveled by the object in unit time in definite direction. Now, in velocity, we specify both magnitude and direction. That is why velocity is a vector quantity. And unit of velocity is same as unit of speed, that is meter per second. Now, we know that in uniform motion, object travels with constant speed in a straight, in a same direction. So, for uniform motion, velocity will be constant throughout the motion. But suppose if the velocity of an object is changing at uniform rate, then instead of velocity, we mention average velocity. And average velocity can be calculated as initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. That is VAV is equal to U, that is initial velocity, plus V, that is final velocity, upon 2. And as I already said, unit of speed and velocity both are same, that is meter per second. Now we will see the difference between speed and velocity. Speed is the distance traveled by an object per second or per unit time is called speed, whereas velocity is the distance traveled per second or per unit time by a moving object in a particular direction is called velocity. Now, in speed, we specify only magnitude, that's why speed is a scalar quantity, and in velocity, we specify both magnitude and direction, so it is a vector quantity. Now, speed is always positive, whereas velocity can be positive, negative, depending upon the direction of motion. Velocity can even be zero. Now, speed, why speed is always positive? Whenever an object is in motion, the speed is always calculated with some positive number only, it cannot be negative. But when we consider, when object is in motion, distance can be calculated by only positive magnitude. Distance traveled by the object is always calculated by positive magnitude, and if we divide positive number by time, the answer will always be positive. But in case of velocity, we calculate displacement. We consider displacement of an object. And as we have already discussed earlier, that displacement can be positive, negative, or zero. And in the same way, velocity is displacement upon time. So, velocity can also be positive, negative, or zero. Now, we will study about rate of change of velocity. Now, when any object is moving in uniform motion, its velocity is always constant throughout the motion. Suppose an object is moving from position A to position B to position C, and at all the three places its velocity is same, that is 80 meter per second. Here also 80 meter per second, and here also 80 meter per second. So you can say an object is moving with uniform velocity. And in this case, if you see the change in velocity means, suppose this is final velocity minus initial velocity. So 80 minus 80 will be 0. So whenever an object is moving with constant velocity, then change in velocity is always zero. So, for uniform motion, you can say that change in velocity is always zero. Now, let us consider non uniform motion. Suppose an object is at position A, then its velocity changes from B and C. Suppose at A its velocity is 0 meter per second, at B its velocity is 20 meter per second, and at C its velocity is 50 meter per second. So here you can see velocity is not constant throughout the motion, and then in this case you can calculate change in velocity. Let us see change in velocity between A and B. So what is the velocity at A? It is 0 meter per second. So that is initial velocity. Initial velocity is represented by u. So u is equal to 0 meter per second, and final velocity, that is at point B, is represented by v. V is final velocity, and it is 20 meter per second. In this case, you can see when change in velocity means final velocity minus initial velocity. It is 20 minus 0 is equal to 20. So you can see that in for non-uniform motion, there is some change in velocity. So the change in velocity of an object during any time interval is not zero here in case of non-uniform motion, and this change in velocity per unit time give rise to a new physical quantity which is known as acceleration. So acceleration is change in velocity per unit time. Okay, the quantity which specify change in velocity is acceleration. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity, or you can say acceleration is change in velocity per unit time. And so the definition of the formula of acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by 2. Suppose if the velocity of body changes from initial velocity u to final velocity v in time t, then acceleration a is equal to v minus u upon 2. And SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. And as acceleration specifies both magnitude and direction, so acceleration is also a vector quantity. Now, acceleration can be uniform and non-uniform. What is uniform acceleration? If an object travels in a straight line and its velocity increases or decreases by equal amount in equal interval of time, then acceleration of object is said to be uniform. Now suppose an object is traveling from position A to D. Now if I calculate the velocity after every 10 seconds, after time is equal to 10 seconds, suppose at A its velocity is 0 meter per second, then after 10 seconds at position B its velocity is 20 meter per second, after 10 seconds, that is at position C, its velocity is 40 meter per second, and at D its velocity is 60 meter per second. So you can see that velocity is increasing, but it is increasing with constant amount by at equal in time interval, that is after every 10 seconds velocity is increasing by 20 meter per second. Now we'll write it properly. Now you can see that velocity is constantly increasing, but it is increasing at equal rate, that is after every 10 seconds it is increasing by 20 meter per second. Okay, now let us find velocity between A and B. Now let us find acceleration between A and B. Now if you simply observe the point A and B, then you can say that initial velocity is u is equal to 0 meter per second. Okay, that is at velocity at A. and v, that is velocity at b, that is final velocity, is 20 meter per second and time interval is 10 second. So let us find acceleration. A is equal to v minus u upon t is equal to 20 minus 0 upon t, that is 10, and that is equal to 2 meter per second square. So acceleration A in this case is equal to 2 meter per second square. Now let us find acceleration between the point B and C. Okay, so let us mention this as acceleration A1. So here A1 we have already calculated as 2 meter per second square. Now let us calculate acceleration at between B and C, that is this. So in this case, initial velocity is 20, final velocity is 40. So acceleration will be 20 final velocity 40 minus 20 by 10, and 40 minus 20 is 20, and 20 by 10 is 2. So let us consider this acceleration as A2. So your A2 is equal to again 2 meter per second square. In the same way, in third case, that is acceleration between C and D. Acceleration between C and D is equal to final velocity 60 minus initial velocity 40 upon 10. 60 minus 40 is 20, 20 upon 10 is 2. Again here it is 2 meter per second square. Now you can see in this journey from A to D, after every 10 seconds, although the speed is continuously increasing, the acceleration is same, that is A1, A2, A3 is 2 meter per second square. And this type of acceleration is known as uniform acceleration, right? So when either the speed is, velocity is continuously increasing or decreasing, but with equal amount, in equal interval of time, then that acceleration is known as uniform acceleration. Now let us see what is non-uniform acceleration. Now suppose an object is traveling from A to D, and if we calculate its velocity after every 10 seconds, suppose at A its velocity is 0 meter per second, at B its velocity is 20 meter per second, at C its velocity is 50 meter per second, and at D its velocity is suppose 10 meter per second. In this case you can see velocity is changing, but with it does not changing changes with equal amount. And in this case, when you will calculate acceleration will be different for each time interval of 10 seconds, and such acceleration is known as non-uniform acceleration. We know that graph provide convenient method to present any basic information about anything. If you want to see compare the cricket score, or if you want to compare the rainfall in various parts of the country, graphical method is very convenient. In the same way, we can represent distance motion on graph in the form of distance time graph. In the graph, distance is taken on y-axis and time is taken on x-axis. The distance time graph for uniform speed is a straight line. This is because in uniform speed, a body travels equal distance in equal interval of time. This graph shows you the uniform motion. You can see in first 5 seconds, distance traveled is 10 meter. Second, in the another slot of 5 seconds, that is after 10 seconds, distance traveled is 20 meter. After 15 seconds, distance traveled is
30 meter, means in every 5 seconds distance traveled is equal to 10 meter. So this is called uniform motion and its graph is straight line. In the same way, in this figure you can see first one is distance time graph of uniform motion, which is straight line. In figure B you can see it is not a straight line. So this represents that this distance is non-uniform motion. This motion is non-uniform motion. In the same way, in case of graph C, again the graph is not a straight line, so this is also non-uniform motion. And the graph D, you can see the distance time graph is parallel to x-axis, means you can see the with increase in the time the distance traveled is constant, means the object is not moving at all. So this is the graph of an object which is at rest or which is stationary. Now from this graph we can derive three equations of motions, which are from the graph we can derive three formulas of motion. Okay, in this the velocity, initial velocity of object is v, u final velocity is v, and it is traveling with uniform acceleration a and in time interval t, and the distance covered is s. Now see, this is the graph for uniform motion. On x-axis we have taken time and on y-axis we have taken distance in meter and time is taken in second. Now as it is uniform motion, equal distance is covered in equal interval of time. Now suppose an object is traveling from O to D, let us name it as D. Okay, now if I want to calculate the distance traveled by an object between position A and position B, at between A to B, then how will I calculate? Now first we will draw two lines parallel to y-axis joining A to x-axis and B to x-axis. Suppose this is object is at position A at time t is equal to t1, and object is at position B at time t is equal to t2. Same way, the distance covered by an object at A is like suppose s1, and distance covered by B at distance covered by object at B is s2. So now the total, if you want to find velocity between A and B, then velocity is equal to total distance upon total time. Now what is the total distance covered between A and B? So total distance covered between A and B, if you want to find, then it will be this s2 minus s1. So you will get the distance covered between A and B. So it will be s2 minus s1. Same way, time taken to cover this distance A to B is t2. This entire t2 minus t1. So you will get this time. So it will be t2 minus t1. So velocity B is equal to s2 minus s1 upon t2 minus t1. In this way, from graph we can find the velocity by using distance and time. Now here you can see velocity time graph. Now here in this graph we take time on x-axis and velocity on y-axis. Time is taken in hour and velocity is taken in kilometer per hour. Now suppose an object is moving with uniform velocity, that is 40 km per hour. Object is constantly moving with uniform velocity. So suppose at time 1 hour velocity is 40 km per hour, at 2 hours also velocity is 40 km per hour, at 3 and 4, after 3 and 4 hour also velocity is 40 km per hour. It means it is moving with constant velocity. Now if I want to find distance traveled by an object from position A to B, then how I will calculate? What is the formula to find velocity? Velocity is equal to distance upon time. And so distance is equal to velocity multiplied by time. Okay, distance is equal to velocity multiplied by time. So we can write distance s is equal to velocity multiplied by time. Now from this figure, object is moving with constant velocity. So velocity is 40. So velocity I'll write 40 and time is equal to how much? So time from A to B is actually t2 minus t1. So t2 minus t1. Now you see the figure, you can say that 40, you can take it as AC. 40 is equal to length of line AC. So AC, and what is t2 minus t1? Actually this t2 minus t1 is CD. Okay, so distance is equal to AC multiplied by CD. So if you consider this as a rectangle, then the distance covered is equal to the area of this rectangle. See, you can see AC multiplied by CD. So length into breadth, and length into breadth means area. So distance is equal to length multiplied by breadth. So that is equal to area of rectangle ABCD. So for any object moving with constant velocity, the distance covered by it is equal to the area under the graph, that is ABCD. Now students, this is the graph of uniform acceleration. Here again on x-axis we will take time in seconds, and on y-axis we will take velocity meter per second. Now here the object is moving with uniform acceleration. It means velocity is increasing with time but in equal amount. Now if here you can see, if I want to find the distance covered by an object from A to E, okay, the graph will be for uniform acceleration, the graph will be like this. Now if I draw two lines parallel to y-axis like this and one line parallel to x-axis, then if I want to calculate distance covered from A to E, then distance will be equal to area under the trapezium A, B, C and E. Now if you see this figure carefully, this is one triangle and one rectangle. So distance covered S is equal to area of rectangle A, B, C, D plus area of triangle A, D, E. So area of rectangle is equal to length multiplied by breadth, that is equal to AB multiplied by BC. Okay, so area of rectangle is AB multiplied by BC plus area of triangle is half base, that is AD into height D. So this, in this way we can calculate the distance covered by an object which is moving with uniform acceleration. Now in this case the velocity is constantly increasing, so the slope is like this. If the velocity is decreasing, then the slope will be like this. And the graph of an object moving with non-uniform acceleration will be something like this. You can see velocity is changing with time but with unequal amount. And so the nature of the graph will be like this. So in this way, from graph we can calculate distance and velocity.